Hi guys, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. So this is a video I honestly really hoped never would surface on the internet, but it has, and people have found it. So I'm so nervous. This is a video that I truly was hoping would never surface on the internet, but here I am, because I found it on the internet the other day and I didn't realize. I kind of figured on Let's Make a Deal, you kind of just like, you go on the show, blah, 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 and then it leaves. I don't know. I guess for some reason, I just never thought that it would show up on the internet for anyone to watch at any time. Well, here we are. So yes, I was on Let's Make a Deal. My friend Anthea actually got to be on it. I don't even know how she got to be on it, but basically she asked if anyone in my house wanted to go on it. And I was like, heck yeah. Like, I want to go on Let's Make a Deal. Like, I'm ready to win a car. It is going to be great. So I get on the phone. First step was a phone call. So I get a casting producer to call me. I'm literally, when she calls me, I just want to like paint the picture. I'm on a date with... I'm just gonna say it, whatever. Anyway, I'm on a date with this guy named Jake. Oh, I don't really know if it was a date, but I kind of considered it a date. We went, we got coffee. It was actually funny because Jess and Gabe, wow, I'm really painting the picture here, guys. So Jess and Gabe Conti, they posted a video called "We're Setting Up One of You with This Guy" or something along the line. And immediately I was like, wait, he's really cute. Like, he's really cute. And so I slid into his little Instagram DMs and I said, hey, actually, let's pull these up because it's fun. This is just gonna go with it. I'm so sorry, Jake. Okay, I found the video, okay? It is called "Setting Up Our Friend with Someone Watching This Video." And so then me, being me, I comment and I said, "Saw the title and I'm in." With like a bunch of hand raising emojis. Next thing you know, I send that to him via Instagram DM. So I like slid into his little DMs and I sent him this screenshot. And I basically said like, "Your DMs have to be blowing up." And he's like, "Hi, like not gonna lie, they definitely have been." And then all of a sudden, we realize that we have like so many mutual friends. He knows my friend Chaz, he knows my friend, like literally my roommate, the one who sleeps right here. He knows her and a bunch of other friends. So I was like, whoa, like this is really weird. Next thing you know, we start talking and he's like, yeah, like wanna go get coffee. Before he even shows up, cause he's running a little bit late, a casting producer calls me and I'm like, this is the worst timing ever. But obviously like I wanna be on the show. So I talked to her, I think for 10 minutes, but then I'm like, is there any way that I could please call you back later? Like just anything. I told her, I was like, I'm on a date right now. Like, can we please? She's like, oh my gosh, absolutely. So I go on my day, we hang out, all that stuff, and then later I hop back in the car, I call her back, we just hit it off so well. But long story short, anywho, I ended up getting on Let's Make a Deal after that went really well, that phone call. And then they also had me do a video call where I had to Skype in. They were recording it and they had me multiple times say who I was, where I was from, and what I do for a living. But you have to be like really excited when you say it. And so I would say like, hi, my name's Courtney, like I'm a YouTuber, blah blah blah. But they actually didn't want me to say that I was a YouTuber. They just thought that that would hurt my chances of being on the show. So they were like, can you say that you work in marketing? And so I was like, okay, whatever. And so I had to keep saying it over and over and over again. But like, just to paint the picture, I'm in my quiet living room. I have three people in the family room, like working quietly. Like they're literally like on Zoom calls and like doing their finance jobs or like nonprofit jobs. So I'm over here like, hi guys, what is up? Like blah, 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 blah. And they just want me to be so high energy. They actually had me do it three separate times because I wasn't being as hype as they wanted me to be. And they kept saying like, just pretend like you're already on the show. Like, what would you say? And I'm like, I don't know. I'm not gonna lie, after the video audition, I really did not think that I got it just because they wanted me to be so hype, like hyper than I could possibly be. They were just like, more, like give us more. And I was like, I can't give you any more. Like there's literally people over here like trying to work it quiet. Like I'm so sorry. So afterwards, I really didn't think I was gonna get it. But a couple days later, they called me and they were like, hey, congratulations. Like we want you to be on Let's Make a Deal. So they scheduled their like my date maybe like a week later and I have to go and I like dress up in a little costume. And honestly, I was very thankful that everyone was just so nice because it was only like 10 or so people. Yeah, so I did play. I'm procrastinating on this, if I'm being honest. So I have not seen this. I refused to watch it because I know what happened. I was there and I feel like this is about to be so cringy. I'm sweating. Right off the bat, you can see me in the background. Oh gosh, I'm so embarrassed. So for the record, I was a barista, but I didn't work for Starbucks, I worked for Zonkbucks. And so that was like my whole costume. And just a little side note, I feel like no one really won on my episode except for one girl. At the very end, she won like $20,000, but no one else really won. I feel like I'm gonna die of embarrassment because I know I'm next.
Before we get there, we need to make a deal with...
Oh gosh.
Zonkbucks. Hey, Courtney. How are you?
I'm great. I'm nervous.
Don't be nervous. Don't be nervous.
I'm ready to make a deal.
That's what we need to hear. So what do you do?
I work in social media marketing, and I make YouTube videos where I get to try crazy Starbucks drinks, hence why I am a barista.
What's the best/weirdest drink you've had from Starbucks?
I had an It-themed drink that was like red and almost like looked like blood, but it was delicious. It was strawberry. Super weird. I've tried like every single secret menu item you could possibly think of.
What's the best secret menu item?
There's a cotton candy frappuccino. That's really good.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Guess what?
What?
Yeah, $1,500. Just like that.
Okay, like... Okay, so far it actually isn't that bad. I will say that. I thought it was going to be a lot worse. I'm not gonna lie. It does get worse.
$1,500. Now, that money could help you win this. Tiffany. It's a new Nissan Versa. Hit the road in this Nissan Versa featuring a continuously variable transmission, 7-inch touchscreen display, Bluetooth streaming audio, and remote keyless entry. On one side of the stage where Tiffany's standing, we have a box. Inside that box, that's the key to the car. On the other side of the stage, we have 15 keys. One of those keys opens the lock that will give you the key to the car. You have 15 seconds to run back and forth trying as many keys as you can. But it's just in 15 seconds. Are you fast?
I gotta be. I'm training for a Spartan race, so I've been hitting the gym.
But I can give you more time. You'd have to buy it from me, though, because you have 15.
Okay, I'm gonna pause it right here, guys. I'm sweating so bad because this is so weird seeing myself. But I also want to go ahead and give you guys a little secret. This didn't play out the way that they edited it. So first, there is no one in front of me. And so when that girl walked up to like show the keys, like the lockbox and the 15 keys, that wasn't in front of me. So whenever he was giving me the directions, there was no one in front of me. And so after he explained in real life, I was like, okay, so I have to keep picking a key, going over to the lock, seeing if it would unlock. And Wayne Brady's like, no, I'm gonna explain this to you again. I'm like literally so confused. I'm like, wait, what are you saying? I'm so confused, like, what do you mean? I was like, I feel like we're saying the same thing. And he tells me one more time, and I literally was like, we're saying the same thing. And he's like, I know, I'm just freaking with you. And I'm like, what the heck? So I'm already just so frazzled, especially because like, it was all theoretical. Like I couldn't see what was actually happening because they were shot at two different times. So I'm looking at nothing as he's trying to describe stuff to me. And then afterward, I run up there and they're like, wait. That's when they like redid it. They brought the model out. She did that little part. And then we started the game.
You'd have to give me $100 per second. So you want to add 15 seconds to give you a total of 30, then you have to give all the money back to me. But let's say you go, oh no, wait, I don't want that. I just want 7 seconds. I want 10 seconds. I want 1 second, or I want no seconds. It's up to you. You have 15 seconds on the clock. How much extra time would you like?
We're just gonna put it all in. Yeah. All in.
Okay, so you now have 30 seconds on the clock. Go get your car.
So right here, again, like I'm running out to nothing. And so they cut the two clips together. And so I'm running out to nothing on the stage, and then they set everything up and then they have me run again. So it's really interesting to see how they cut this. But just for the record, for one, I was gonna either go big or go home with nothing. That was my thought process throughout this whole thing. But they gave me the hardest game, dude. Usually it's like a 1 in 3. They're like, pick a curtain. But I got a 1 in 15 chance.
Pick your first key, one key at a time.
Number 10.
All right, even if you're correct, you have to unlock the lock before 0. 30 seconds on the clock. Ready, set, go. Key, all right, first key down.
Number 7.
I think she can try 2 more keys, baby. Key 4, give her a big round of applause.
Courtney, do you want to try key 4?
Yeah, Courtney.
Four,
so Thank you for playing, Courtney.
Thank you.
More Let's Make a Deal right after this.
Okay, I'm actually, wait a second. For one, I am sweating. I don't know if you guys can tell. Yeah, I am so red. I actually wasn't as bad as I thought that it would be. I'm not gonna lie. Because that was so quick. That was like a 30 second clip. But for me, like, I think I was total doing this for like 20 minutes. Them like explaining it, calling me down there, them setting stuff up. So for me, it was like a really long time. So I'm very happy that it went so quickly. Okay, so another little piece of information is right after this, I went to my seat, and I'm not gonna lie, I was also really afraid of, like, cause you don't know the facial expressions you make after you lose something like that. And so I was really nervous that I was gonna come across like, I don't know, I wasn't sure what kind of face I made, cause you're just so in the moment, you're like, oh no. So I was really nervous about that, but I think it actually came across as very graceful. So I'm very happy with that. And honestly, it's really not as bad as I thought that it was going to be. But I go to my seat, and the reason why I thought it was so bad too is because when I went to my seat, Wayne Brady comes up to me and he's like, hey, I checked out some of your YouTube videos. You're really funny. And so I'm like, thank you. And he's like, I'm so sorry you didn't win the car. And I was like, oh my, like, not a big deal. But then I had another producer come up to me and say, whoa, Courtney, we have never had someone do five keys, like ever. We've never had someone hit five keys. And they were like, you did such a good job. And I was like, oh, thank you. And then later on in the show, I had another producer come up to me, and they weren't going up to other people. That's why I was so confused, because I was like, was mine so cringy that that's why everyone's coming up to me to like make me feel better? I honestly didn't know. And so I had another one come up to me, and they were like, hey, I just want to say again, like, so sorry you didn't win the car. You know, a couple times a year, we actually have zonk episodes where we bring people on that got zonked. And so they were like, yeah, like, keep an eye out for an email. Like, I'm sure you'll get it, like, an email about it. And I was like, oh, like, wow, thank you. I'm telling you, they didn't do this to anyone else in the audience. So that's why I was like, I left being like, oh my gosh, it must have been so cringy that they needed to tell me this so that I didn't get upset or something. I don't know. I was so nervous, but I am gonna keep watching it or like scroll through, because I really wanna see if there's any other parts that I'm in. Wait, I have to show you guys this because this was so flipping funny. This girl was such a hoot. She starts twerking. She was like a twerking donut.
Hey there.
Hey, Wayne.
Hey.
Sorry.
She was so fun.
You just made my day. A twerking donut. Two things that a brother loves. Would you like to win $20,000?
Yeah.
Let's play Smash for Cash.
Number three.
I see money. $1.
Okay, you're two away. No, no, at all. That's man.
Donut.
Hey.
Whoa, did anyone else just realize I made the same face? I made the same face here as I just did on here.
Away from $1,000.
Money.
Ooh. Money, money, money.
Looks like.
With everyone, she just keeps dorking. Wait, we're gonna fast forward because my camera's dying. Okay, this girl was literally so fun, and just for like her energy and her twerking, like, I feel like she deserved $20,000. Also, what's really interesting is she was the very last person whenever we were actually filming, and so I think it's really interesting they like rearranged the order of the people. Oh my gosh. Okay, wait. That was not as horrible as I thought it was going to be. I thought this was about to be humiliating. I thought this was going to be the worst thing that I have ever put on the internet. But no, I think that it was really graceful. And it was so much fun, guys. Like, I got to like hang out with a bunch of people. We weren't allowed to have our phones on us, so we didn't really like keep in contact with anyone. But we got to hang out like literally all day. And it was just really fun. But honestly, I'm overall just like super thankful for the opportunity. And yeah, so that was my Let's Make a Deal appearance. Again, wasn't as cringy as I thought it was going to be, but it is still a little cringe. But overall, I really did have a really fun time. So if you guys have ever been on a game show, comment it down below, because I think that'd be really interesting. Also, comment this little emoji if you made it all the way to the end. I love you guys. Subscribe if you guys have not already subscribed, and I will see you guys later. Bye.